A fourth COVID-19 shot may be on its way. Moderna asking for FDA approval ahead.
Hey guys, I'm live here from the DI Hub kitchen where the Great Kent Bake Off is taking place. Stay tuned to see what's cooking.
And Ashton Kutcher and Mila Kunis have reached their $30 million goal. Now, exactly how many people took part in this fundraiser?
And a 97-year-old woman reaching one of her lifelong goals. All this as TV2 News starts right now.
This is TV2 News.
Heyo, Portage County, and thank you for joining us. I'm Shane Troyano.
And I'm Gabby Jonas.
And we start tonight with Abigail Forbes live at the Great Kent Bake Off taking place at the DI Hub.
Students are putting their culinary skills to the test as we speak. Now, Abby, how's it going over there?
Hey guys, yeah, I'm live here with the Kent State Safety and the Inner Hall Council where they're hosting this Great Kent Bake Off. I'm here with Nora. Nora, can you just kind of tell us a little bit about this event?
Yeah, so it's basically a spin off of the Great British Baking Show. We wanted to come up with a program to engage everyone and have a little fun, get something that they could get out of it too, because they get to keep their own cupcakes.
Amazing.
We're making cupcakes today, so.
And so how many teams do we have here today?
We have 16 teams, so we're going to go in two shifts for teams, yeah.
Amazing. And I heard you guys have some trivia going on at the same time. Can you kind of explain that?
We do. So while your stuff is baking, you'll be playing trivia, so to keep you engaged.
Amazing.
Yes.
And so what kind of made you guys want to create this event?
We wanted to do something fun that a lot of people could relate to and something that would be easily accessible. And we wanted to use this space because it's so great here. There's so many opportunities here at the DI Hub.
Yeah. And so stay tuned because this competition is heating up. I'm Abigail Forbes for TV2 News, reporting live.
Thanks, Abby. All right, now, Ohio troopers are investigating a fatal crash that took place this morning on I-76 westbound in Portage County, killing one and injuring another. According to the Ohio State Highway Patrol, a vehicle caught fire and two people that got out of it were then hit by a semi-truck. Those people, a 50-year-old Akron man that was killed and a 29-year-old taken to the hospital. Routes 225 and 14 were closed for over an hour, but it is now open and traffic is continuously moving. And the Portage Park District is conducting controlled burns at two of its parks to help with land management. Controlled burns may happen within 30 acres of meadow habitat to reduce woody stems and propagate native herbaceous plants. The fires will take place at Dix Park on Route 44 in Ravenna Township and Morgan Park on Route 44 in Shalersville. Now, the fire will be conducted by an Ohio-certified fire manager. Necessary permits were obtained from the Ohio Division of the Forestry and the Ohio EPA. All right, now let's take a look at what is going on today with the weather around Portage County. So we're going to take a look. It feels like 70 and it is 70. Perfect weather right now. Have a dew point at 40 degrees. And if you are planning on going on a picnic, guess what? You can definitely see where you're going today.
Across Ohio, we see all sunny skies with 70 across the state. The coldest is actually 54 up in Cleveland. Oh, sorry, Sandusky, 44. They did not get the lucky weather this evening. But across the state, we're still seeing sunny skies and 70-degree weather.
I love how it's 70 degrees,
70 degrees
all across Ohio.
Yes.
Poor Sandusky, though. Poor Cedar Point.
So sad.
Hey, it's opening soon. All right, now from going to 8 p.m. to midnight, 8 a.m., it's definitely going to be lowering in degree and going down to the 60s and then moving down to just 56 and 55 degrees. It's going to be a little rainy tonight, so make sure you get your umbrellas if you are going out. And we are going to continuously not get a lot of rain. And then we're going to get some more rain in the morning. All right, and that is all we have for now. So stay tuned for your full forecast later on in the show.
Going into this weekend and the week ahead, Ohio will be entering severe weather awareness week, March 20th through the 26th. The Portage County Office of Homeland Security and Emergency Management will be spreading awareness. This time of the year, to help residents prepare for the different weather awareness, will be announced via social media. March 23rd is the annual statewide tornado drill starting at 9:50 a.m.
And Secretary of State Frank LaRose has paused a couple preparations for the May 3rd primary, all because of a third court decision invalidating GOP-drawn maps of new legislative districts. LaRose issued a directive to county election boards Thursday with a letter to the Ohio Redistricting Commission. He said counties are now, quote, simply out of time to complete the work necessary to hold state house elections as scheduled.
And two men were arrested today after several drug searches were made in Butler County. 43-year-old Vince Sanford and 36-year-old John Andrews Jr. were arrested and charged on multiple drug and gun-related offenses. Police said nine search warrants were made for the alleged drug organizations that found 700 pounds of marijuana, 10 guns, and vehicles. Police say the drug group is said to be involved in a large drug trafficking group and death-related shooting in 2021. And today, evacuations were made after a complex fire in Texas.
And if you are an Eagles fan, you might like this one, because on today's Health Minute, why you keep rooting for the underdogs. So in case you didn't know, Eagles are considered the underdogs, but it's okay. If you don't know, it's okay. Stick with us.
Welcome to my block party. Glad you can make it.
I can do this all day. Your moves are just gay.
Using gay to mean dumb or stupid, not cool.
Not in my house, not anywhere.
It's not creative.
It's offensive to gay people.
And you're better than that.
I rescued Toast from a shelter in 2011. I love Toast because she's a lazy diva. Toast does whatever she wants, obviously. She's sleeping right now. She's an epic snuggler. She's so comforting. She's so loving. Toast makes me laugh. When I walked into the shelter, I knew right then that she was special.
Thank you for sticking with us. Lots of health stories coming in today. One's concerning COVID-19 vaccines, and one's concluding Biden announcing a new health agency. So let's switch it over to Gabby to discuss today's Health Minute. Hi, Gabby.
Hey, Shane. So starting with the ARPA-H, today President Biden met with researchers and patients to discuss a new cutting-edge health research agency. The agency will accelerate progress on curing cancer and other health-related innovations called ARPA-H. ARPA-H is based off of the Advanced Defense Department research on this going issue. It will drive breakthroughs for biomedicine to, in Biden's words, prevent, protect, and treat diseases including cancer, Alzheimer's, and diabetes. Moderna has also asked for FDA approval to release a fourth COVID booster for adults. Rivals with Pfizer, the request from Moderna is broader than Pfizer's. A press release stated that the request was made to provide flexibility. U.S. health officials currently recommend two doses of Moderna vaccine and a booster dose for months later. And reporter Amanda Geether gives us an inside look as why March Madness and cheering for the underdog gets us excited. Take a look.
March Madness is here. You may find yourself jumping on the underdog bandwagon, and your brain is what's driving you there, says Jamie Houle, a sports psychologist with the Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center.
It's almost gratifying when folks that are supposed to win don't.
Houle says there's a science behind the desire to pull for the underdog. First, we can relate to them, even if we're not aware of it.
What it makes us believe is that maybe at some point we might be able to do something great. Overcome some kind of odds that seem like overwhelming.
There's always an expectation that the best teams will win, but when that doesn't happen, Houle says we find joy in the unexpected.
When we see people who are really great mess up, it makes us go, okay, cool, maybe I'm not that different than everybody else.
Many times fans root against a team as much as they root for one. Houle says that's our brain's way of wanting things to be fair.
We want justice, so we want things to be kind of equal, and when they're not equal, that doesn't really feel good to us.
Indianapolis Underdog.
And finally, we often find an unexpected outcome to simply be more exciting.
We want chaos because it's kind of more fun to watch than the regular things we do every day.
For Health Minute, I'm Mandy Gaither.
Welcome back. As promised, we have the rest of your weather report this Friday evening, so let's take a look. All right, so as we go into 70 degrees still throughout
Ohio.
So what do you think about that?
I think it's great. I'm ready for the warm weather. We're seeing 70 across the state, and unfortunately for Cincinnati, they're the lowest right now with 65.
Still not as bad as Sandusky at 40.
Still not as bad as Sandusky. But sunny skies for the rest of us, so that's good. It's good to see. I'm ready to break out the weather clothing for this
time of year. As we move into your 7-day forecast, tomorrow we are going to see 37, unfortunately, but the high is 60. So we got a long spread of that weather. It's going to rain tomorrow, so make sure you get your raincoats, your umbrellas. But as we move into the week, we definitely see a rise. That sun is creeping out and the heat
coming
from those rays is coming out. Coming to a 68 on Monday, and then going back down to a 56. The clouds are kind of coming back, but on Sunday and Monday, we do get those clouds. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, it is going to be cloudy. Wednesday, Thursday, going to rain, but we still get those nice temperatures. Friday next week, we will see that sun come out once again, but at a 50 degrees, so not as nice as today. But you definitely should get your nice warm weather in this week.
Still going to see that peak of sunshine, so that's good to see.
That's exciting. Well, if you need any more updates, please look at KentWire.com for all of your news, sports, entertainment, and weather updates.
Must remind the public, it is Moscow that has long maintained a biological weapons program in violation of international law, not Ukraine. It is Moscow that has a well-documented history of using chemical weapons, not Ukraine. And it's Moscow that started this senseless war.
Earlier today, the U.S. and allies, including Albania, France, Ireland, Norway, and the United Kingdom, discussed the accusations made about Russia using the U.N. Security Council with the attempt to launder disinformation. The conspiracy story started after Moscow's representative accused the U.S. of engaging in biological weapon projects in Ukraine. The meeting was held to hold Russia accountable for their actions. On a brighter note, Ashton Kutcher and Mila Kunis raised $30 million for Ukraine. Ukraine being Kunis' home country, the famous actors had a goal and made it happen. More than 65,000 people donated to the campaign through GoFundMe, and in their words, the couple is overwhelmed with gratitude. Take a look.
We just want to say that we hit our goal.
Over $30 million raised.
Over 65,000 of you donated. We are overwhelmed with gratitude for the support. And while this is far from a solve of the problem, our collective effort will provide a softer landing for so many people as they forge ahead into their future of uncertainty.
$30 million, that is incredible. All right, now the U.S. House on Friday passed legislation that would ban race-based hair discrimination in employment and against those participating in federally assisted programming, such as housing programs and public accommodations. The House voted 235-189 to pass the Crown Act, a bill seeking to protect against bias based on hair texture and protective styles. The bill now heads to the Senate, where Senator Cory Booker has sponsored the chamber's version. The Biden administration this week said it, quote, strongly supports the Crown Act. And the Eastland Complex fire in Texas has forced evacuations Friday. The Texas A&M Forest Service estimates it has burned more than 45,000 acres and is only 4% contained. Hundreds of homes were evacuated as crews worked to construct fire lines to protect residential and commercial buildings. The Forest Service is using several air tankers and helicopters in an effort to contain this massive blaze. All over the country, police are seeing an increase in reports on people hurting one another, including children, using an alleged social media challenge. The, quote, Orbeez challenge involves people using toy guns designed to fire gel or water-based pellets. The manufacturer of Orbeez, Spin Cycle, has since responded to reports of teenagers who may be misusing its beads, which are toys for children ages 5 and up. It said, quote, Orbeez are designed for educational, creative, and sensory play and are not intended to be used as projectiles or inserted in mechanisms.
MAC Championships and March Madness, what more can you ask for? Stay tuned for the Sports Report for a look into all things athletics.
And finally, a new hard hat emoji for all us Gen Zers and many more when we return.
The inherent right to work is one of the elemental privileges of a free people, endowed as our nation is with abundant physical resources, and inspired as it should be with the high purpose to make those resources and opportunities available for the enjoyment of all. We approach this problem of re-employment with the real hope of finding a better answer than we have now.
And now, your TV2 Sports Report.
Welcome back. Thank you for sticking with us, Portage County. Now, University of Pennsylvania swimmer Leah Thomas made history Thursday by becoming the first transgender woman to win an NCAA swimming competition in Division I. Thompson, entering as the top seed, finished the 500-yard freestyle with a season best time of 4 minutes, 33.24 seconds.
However, protesters against allowing Thomas to compete made their voices heard. Signs were held saying save women's sports, and some did not cheer when they saw she won.
The nice weather and March Madness this month, sports are all the talk.
Our sports reporter Ben McMillen has more. Hi, Ben.
Good evening and happy Friday, Portage County. My name is Ben McMillen with the TV2 Sports Report. Getting things started with gymnastics. The KSU squad took a trip to Ypsilanti, Michigan to face off against the other conference teams in the 2022 MAC Championships. The Golden Flashes find themselves at a high point of the year following a season's best performance on Sunday against Western Michigan. The strong end to the season cemented MAC honors for five gymnasts. Rachel Dukavich, Carly Franz, Alyssa Guns, Sarah Haxton, and of course, Cami Klein, who are all named to the All-Conference second team. The meet is set to kick off Saturday morning, and TV2's very own Della Fowler will be there to cover all the action. And the Kent State wrestling team had a pair of representatives take the stage at the NCAA National Championships. Cody Kamara and Colin McCracken earned the trip to Detroit, and opening day was highlighted by an opening round victory by McCracken over Northwestern's Jack Jessup. McCracken found himself down early but stormed back in the final 30 seconds to take the victory for the Flashes. The opening round victory was the sole win of the trip to the championships, rounding out a 7-7 record for the season highlighted by impressive end of the year performances. And taking things to March Madness, we have Sister Jean and the Loyola Ramblers taking a trip to Pittsburgh PPG Center. See Malachi Branham with the steal, working it to the other end for the Brand Slam. Ohio State up early. They're not looking to get upset here by Loyola. And on the other end, Lucas Williams trying to get by Jamiri Wheel, finds Braden Norris in the corner for the splash. Loyola hanging early, looking to play upset yet again. EJ Liddell, see him, sees top of the key, collapses on him, but he skies above the defenders and finds home. Such a skilled offensive player, we see Liddell working through the defense, skying above the defenders, he can do it all. And we see him on the other end too, creating a little bit of space. One dribble to the right, goes over the same defender, that's a center that he's reaching over. EJ Liddell can do it all offensively. With 8:30 left, Loyola looking to hang, Ryan Schwieger finds it on the wing and cuts it to single digits with less than 10 minutes left, but the Ohio lead would prove to be too much for the Ramblers. Buckeyes pushing it up the court, Liddell to Eugene Brown to end things with an exclamation point. The Buckeyes leave the PPG Paint Center with a 54-41 win and move on to face off with the Wildcats of Villanova. Now some NFL news, as the Cleveland Browns reportedly have a deal in place for Houston Texans quarterback Deshaun Watson. The trade is still being finalized, but the Browns are reportedly sending 3 first-round picks, 1 third-round pick, and 1 fourth-round pick to Houston. Watson is also in line to sign an extension to keep him in Cleveland long-term. Watson will face discipline from the NFL for sexual conduct allegations. He could face a suspension for next season. And that will wrap up our Friday Sports Report. As always, tune into Sports Corner on Monday at 8, and follow us on Twitter at TV2KSU Sports. I've been Ben McMillen. Have the best weekend, Portage County.
Thanks, Ben. All right, a feel-good story coming up. A 97-year-old woman making her dreams come true. Love to see it. Stick with us.
Hey, did you know that 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Go to theshelterpetproject.org and search your local shelters and rescues. Go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.
Hamilton was adopted from a rescue in 2008.
He's quite the pug about town. He gets invited to a lot of parties.
He knows he's a pretty big deal. How could you not love him?
Tomorrow's news leaders.
Today's top stories.
From an award-winning student newsroom.
This is TV2 News, truly Portage County.
Welcome back. The creators took the world of emoji and created 115 new emojis to spice up your texting. More diversity emojis were made to showcase all races.
Even more wild emojis showcase a pregnant man, troll, and even a cute heart hand emoji. Other emojis can be seen after downloading Apple's iOS 15.4 update.
All right. Well, I love to see that, too. That's really cool. But this is another story I like to see. A 97-year-old woman recently completed something off of her bucket list. I think she completed her bucket list of visiting all 50 states.
Yes. Her good friend helped her fulfill her mission with a trip to Rhode Island. Sam Reed has a story.
While the Ocean State is a popular place for people to visit, especially in the summer months, 97-year-old Helen Raines and her friend Jan Ross recently made it their mission to travel from their state of South Carolina to Rhode Island.
I needed Rhode Island. That was my last state I hadn't been in.
Jan recently learned her longtime friend had been to all 49 other states.
I said, Helen, you can't, you know, pass on without getting that last one in, so let's try and do it. So for Christmas, that was her Christmas present.
And so time wouldn't fly by without her seeing the smallest state. The pair hopped aboard a plane and headed for Providence.
They had the wheelchairs for me at all the airports, and I was treated royally.
An overnight stay at the Renaissance Hotel was just what the doctor ordered.
We drank a little, and we ate, and we slept a little.
But when the ladies were treated to a tour at the Capitol, well, that was something so sentimental.
And that was the highlight. It was really unbelievable. I couldn't begin to describe it to anyone. And they were just very, very conciliatory. Truly the most gracious group of employees I've ever run across. They were delightful.
Welcomed with a citation from Governor Dan McKee, these Southern Belles learned a lot about Southern New England.
Don't call people in Rhode Island Yankees, you know, like they do down here. Everybody was very, very nice. They were lovely.
Within 24 hours, a dream destined hundreds of miles away was made true.
It's just sort of a milestone for us both. I mean, I was just happy that I was able to facilitate her achieving that goal because I just hated for her not to do it.
And while the best of her bucket list is complete, Helen says while it may be the smallest state, it left the biggest impression.
You know the expression, you know, best for last. That's how I feel about Rhode Island.
I absolutely love hearing stories about that.
Oh, me too. It's so heartwarming to see that she finally got her last date.
I know.
Yeah.
And it's just absolutely incredible to see you can do anything at any age, no matter what anybody says. She went to Rhode Island. Like,
have
that's
you been
incredible.
To Rhode Island?
I've never been to Rhode Island.
Neither have I.
Has there been any state or any location that you wanted to go to?
Yes.
That's on your bucket list?
I really wanted to go to Colorado, and I went a long time ago.
Wow. Yeah. Nice job.
Yeah, skiing. So fun. What about you? Where do you want to go?
Well, I recently just checked off a bucket list.
Okay.
I've always wanted to go to New York City, and I recently been able to do that, so that's
New
been
York?
Pretty cool.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's so fun. Now, emojis. What's your what's your top five?
Butterfly, heart, fairy.
Okay. That's three, but it's okay.
Well, that is all the time we have for you tonight, and that wraps up our Friday evening.
For all these stories and more, go to our newly redesigned KentWired.com and follow us on social media, KentWired. I'm Gabby Jonas.
And I'm Shane Troyano. Thanks for sticking with us, and have a great night, Portage County. Hey, yo.
Read to a child today and spark a lifetime of ambition.
Come on! Go, Diane! Yeah, keep it going! Yeah, 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 yeah! Go, 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 honey!
If you love them enough to drive an hour to cheer them on as they get beat 11 to nothing in the rain, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're correctly buckled in the back seat.
Throw that ball, Diane. Woo! You got this!
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.